Welcome back, everyone. I have not been editing dinosaur videos. Instead, I have been enjoying Halloween and my 40th birthday. We worked on the Jeep some. I ordered a new car. We researched a new computer that my husband's going to build for me so that I can edit and include more effects and transitions and other things, and because the current one doesn't want to do that anymore. What else have I been doing? I had family visit in October. I am getting ready for another visit for Christmas. The kids are coming, and that's awesome. The weather's been like gorgeous, and I've been sewing. And this is my latest acquisition. I know everyone else is talking about the Jurassic art book. I also have that, but this is one of the coolest old books I've got in a while. This is the Better Homes and Gardens sewing book. I also have, I think, their cookbook and their gardening book. So this is kind of like another collection of things that I have. But anyway, Better Homes and Gardens, resource for domestic types for decades. And this is in amazing shape. It has all of the pages. It even has the little protector for the first page and the little protector for the last page. We have a cover and the table of contents. Each section has its own table of contents. And in the back, we also have an index. And this book is really great if you want to learn how to sew, because it starts at the beginning with the absolute basics. It tells you all kinds of sewing equipment, whether you're going to sew by hand or with a machine. It tells you about irons and ironing boards and other tools. Like, you know, if you don't know what a ham is, this tells you all about it. A ham is used for ironing. Actually have one. This is my ham. I purchased this one, but this book actually tells you like how to make things as well. So I could have made my own ham if I had this book first. Talks about patterns, and basically this whole middle section of the book here is all about basic garments, basic tailoring, like to make, if you ever wanted something to like fit you perfectly, to accentuate every little curved nook cranny, have snapped cuffs and collars and all of that. This book tells you how to adjust patterns and how to adjust garments to make that happen. It'll show you like the shapes of basic patterns. Tells you how to make certain things, like here's instructions on how to make a collar. We have tips for dresses and how to do like inserts and trim and cording and closures and all of that. And then it also has sections for men's clothing. This talks about altering patterns and making your own patterns, which I have done some and is not easy, but these tips in here are great. I did browse through them. Altering for fuller figures. This section here tells you everything you ever wanted to know about making curtains, bedspreads, dust ruffles, couch covers, you know, anything you needed for the home furnishing kind of things. Valances, canopy bed covers. Just anything you could think of that you want for your home. Basic bedding and drapery and stuff like that is in this section. And yet, like bathing suits, it tells you, describes basically every kind of pattern you can think of and gives you tips on how to make it fit right, tips on how to work with different fabrics, tips on how to insert trim, like I said, the different kinds of stitches it recommends for things. Let's see, where was the this is a good section for tailoring, but this section here, I think it is. Yeah, this talks all about fabric and how to lay out patterns, and especially something that most people struggle with. If you're going to use prints or plaids or stripes, they are the literal devil. Like, they are Satan's fabric. And you have to be very careful when you're laying out a pattern. Otherwise, you'll get a design in a weird spot, or a stripe right up your butt, or, you know, something weird that you don't want, like a big old arrow pointing to an area you don't want to emphasize. And it has, like, these say right and wrong, which is, I wish they had used better terminology, but that's what they had back when this was written. It's their recommended placement for patterns so that they are more flattering on the form. You see this one here, she's got the flower like in the middle of her chest, and this one here, it's like staggered down the body like it is on the pattern on the fabric. And she has one in her crotch and on her knees, and here she's got it kind of accentuating her hip a little bit, and then, you know, diagonal. So it's not necessarily like wrong, but there are ways to make it more flattering and to have it emphasize some parts instead of emphasizing weird parts. Tells you how to match up designs. So if you, like, this one has a nice diamond pattern, if you want the diamond pattern to match up in the middle of the dress, it tells you how to lay it out. Talks about stripes, and basically their tip is to line up the notches on the pattern with similar stripes. So when you cut it and you sew it together, you have, you know, this side notch matched up with that one. And if you both have a stripe, then your stripe is going to go all the way around the garment. Like it so. It also talks about diagonals, how to get them to go different ways if you want them to, and plaid, the nightmare. You can see how, you know, one looks a little weird and one matches up. These actually do match up in the middle. And then because it's not just a straight skirt, you have the pattern that kind of slants out a little bit, but it still matches up in the middle, which is nice. Talks about dealing with sleeves and how to fix your stripes on your sleeves to get them to line up right. Basically, I mean, this is a really great chapter if you work with patterned fabric at all. Again, not gospel, but just really great tips and suggestions for you to try. Troubleshooting for every kind of, like, if it's got a weird gather in the shoulder, or if it's got a puffy spot, or if it's got a poofy spot on your butt, or if the line goes weird on the side of your body. Talks about, you know, how to adjust it so that it lays right. Of course, you do that on your muslin before you cut out your regular fabric, because you want to make sure you have your pattern all set before you start on the expensive fabric. But this talks about assembling a pattern, like how the steps in what order to put things in the dress so that you don't have to deal with not being able to get to a seam. Talks about pressing and finishing edges. So much stuff. Like, you could read this for months. And it's really just a great reference to keep around, so you can, like, either go to the index or the table of contents and, like, I need to find out about buttonholes. You know, so full of tips and tricks. I'm enamored with it already. Key accessories to suit color. Wardrobe planning. Something I didn't expect to find in here. Tips on how to coordinate your wardrobe. Awesome. Well, anyway, so that's what I've been doing. I've been sewing, and I hope to be changing up a little bit. It's going to turn into more of a variety channel. I'll make a video about that later. But if you're into hobbies like sewing, embroidery, crafts, stuff like that, I'm gonna have a few videos about that, I think. And it just makes more sense for me to put the content I want on my channel instead of just having it be one thing that's difficult. And like I said, I'll make another video about that. But that is a basic overview of the Better Homes and Gardens sewing book. Does it have a year of publication on it? Sewing information. It does change, but it changes very, very slowly. And like the basics of sewing from like the beginning of written history are the same, essentially. So, I mean, you're taking two flat pieces of something, sewing them together with a needle and thread or other lacing, and turning them into a 3D something. That hasn't changed. I don't see publication information about book, but just based on what I know, I'm guessing 50s, 60s, something like that, mid-century. The artwork is, mid-century-ish. If you look at the house here, you can see looks like a 50s house to me, or 60s. But anyway, yeah. Great resource if you want to learn how to sew. Tons and tons of information. I could never cover it all. It would take years and years to go through everything in the book in detail. But just a great resource to have if you'd like to learn how to sew. I still have more dinosaur stuff to edit and post, so don't throw a fit if you don't see dinosaur stuff. It's coming. I just have to deal with my computer being a pain, and I'm busy and I'm enjoying life, and I'll try to keep you updated and post more often. And until then, happy sewing.